Hello students, in earlier videos we had learned types of these tile sheets. Okay, now in this lecture we will start here new topic, that is CSS selectors. Okay, what is mean by CSS selectors? What are the types of CSS selectors? So we will learn the types of selectors one by one. Okay, now so first concept is, what is mean by selector? We know that what is CSS. CSS is the cascading style sheet. But what is mean by selector here? Okay, why we use the selectors in CSS? Okay, this is the new concept. So when we study about selectors, selectors are being used to target one or more HTML element to apply our CSS rules. Correct. When we design our style sheet, we apply some CSS rules, correct? When we want to design or we want to style the H1 tag, then there are number of properties and their values and selectors are there. Okay? So when we selectors are used, the selectors are related to what? Related to the HTML elements. And we want to design the given HTML elements or style the given HTML elements, then it is treated as the selectors. Okay? Now, as we know that CSS syntax is divided into two parts, that is selector and declaration block. Okay? CSS syntax is divided into what? CSS syntax is divided into two parts, that is selector and declaration block. Like when we design the, okay, we will understand this selector here. When we design H1, then use a curly bracket, then suppose color, I want to color here red. Then here is what? H1 is what? H1 is the selector. Correct. H1 is what? H1 is the selector and color is the property of that selector and red is the value of that selector. Okay. So when we talk about selectors, selectors are being used to target one or more HTML elements to apply our cascading style sheet rules. Okay. So there are number of types of selectors. There are different kinds of selectors that we use in CSS, and they are there. Okay. First type is what? ID selector, then class selector, universal selector and group selectors. So first of all, or in this video you will learn about the ID selectors. Okay. So what is mean by ID selector here? When we talk about ID selectors, it selects the ID attribute of an HTML element to select a specific element. Okay, when we want to select the specific element, then which selector use? That is ID selector. Because ID is the identifier of particular things, okay, or particular data. So ID selector, the name indicates that it selects the specific elements or specific things, okay. So it is related to select a specific element which is in the form of an HTML element, okay. And ID is always unique within the page, so it is unique element, okay. And listen properly here, that is ID is the unique element. That means suppose the same type of elements are there, then we can't say that these numbers are ID or identifiers, okay. So ID is what? ID is the unique throughout the document. That means the ID is not same, or the same name repeated 3 times or 4 times, then we can't say that this is the ID. Okay, ID is the unique element within your document. Clear? And it is written with the hash character. Okay, and it is written with the help of what? Hash character followed by the ID name. Okay, so we will discuss this ID selector with the help of one program. Okay. Okay, this is the example of ID selector. Example of ID selector. Okay, so how to write the ID selectors? Okay, so first of all, write down your HTML, then head within the head I give you one title, that is ID selector demo, then title close, Then within the style tag is always written in head section. So within the style tag, ID selector is designed. Okay. So hash is used for creating the ID selectors. Okay, hash followed by your ID selector name. That is, I want to give here what heading one. Okay, I want to give here heading one, and within that, I set some property of that selectors. That is text aligned to center and color what blue. Okay, so text align colon center, then semicolon, color colon blue. Okay, so this line what? This line is what the? This is the creation of the ID selector. Okay, what? Creation of ID selector. Then close the style tag. Then close head tag here. Then open the body tag. Okay. When we open body tag, then use the H1 tag. Okay. H1 tag, and I want to use here what? ID. ID keyword or ID attribute of the what? Input tag or style tag. Okay. Then ID is equal to heading 1. Okay. Whatever name you want to give here, so as it is name, you have to write down here. Okay. ID is equal to in double quote heading 1. So what happens when this line executes? When this line executes, the control goes to where? Here. Control goes to this line and execute this one. That is text align to center and color the given data with blue color. Correct. So what is the text within this H1 tag? That is welcome to ID selector demo. So this text is colored with blue and it is aligned with aligned to what? Aligned to the center. Okay. Then H1 close it. Understand this one? Okay. Next, I want to print some information related to the ID selector. So I have to use here what? P tag. P for paragraph tag. So ID selector is one type of selector which selects the ID attribute of an HTML element to select a specific element, and paragraph tag is close here, and then body close, and then HTML close here. Only this line is new for you, that is H1 ID is equal to heading 1. When this line executes, the control goes to this line, hash a heading 1, then text align to center and color to blue. Okay. This is what? This is the ID attribute of the HTML element. Okay. That is heading 1. ID is the attribute of the heading 1 tag here. Clear? Understand? So we will execute this program practically and we will see the output of the output of this program. Okay. Now we will start here execution of ID selector. Okay. So now first type HTML tag, HTML, second head. Okay. Next title. What is the title? That is ID selector demo. Okay. Then title close. Okay. Next, use style tag. Style. Okay. Use style tag. In that style, you have to create one ID selector. Okay. ID selector is how to write ID selector? That is, you want to use your what? Hash followed by the ID selector name. So in our example, what is the ID selector name? That is heading 1. Okay, you want to give any name. Okay, I want to use your what? Heading 1. Instead of heading 1, you want to use any name. Okay, so I want to use your what? Heading 1. Next, curly bracket open, text align center. Okay, semicolon, next color blue. Okay, that means I want to use here what? Two properties, that is text align and color. Clear? Then close the style tag. Style tag,
then close head tag. Understand? Next, open body tag here. Okay, suppose I want to change the BG color. Is equal to yellow. Okay. Next, use heading 1 tag. So H1 space. Here use one attribute, that is ID attribute of the HTML element. ID is equal to, in double quote, write down or type here what? Heading 1. Okay. So when you type your heading 1, the properties of heading 1 are what? Text align to center and color to blue. Okay. So type your one text, that is welcome to ID selector demo. Okay, then close H1. Okay, next I want to use here P tag. P, then write something about ID selector, that is ID selector is 1 type of selector which selects the ID attribute of an HTML elements to select a specific element. Okay, then close your paragraph tag. Okay, next enter, then close body tag and then close HTML tag. Understand this one? Okay, so save this document. I want to save this file on desktop. So save this document with the name. Suppose I want to give a name, ID selector demo.html. Understand? Then save this. Okay, so on desktop one file is created, that is ID selector demo. So double click on it and then see the result. It takes some time to open. Okay, so see here output. That is, welcome to ID selector demo is in the color of blue and is aligned to what? Center. And then we have to use P tag for displaying some text. Okay, this is the output of your program. If I want to add one more ID selector here, then for what? For P tag. So use here hash. Suppose I want to give her name, that is para. Okay, and then curly bracket open and close, and I want to align the text align to center, okay, semicolon. Then I want to what at the border of that paragraph. So what border attribute is used? Border colon solid. Suppose the value is solid, and then I want to change the size of the font. Okay, so font size is equal to, okay, sorry, equal to now is given, that is colon, that is I want to give here 20 pixels px. Okay, and save this document and see the output. So just refresh this page, no output is there. Why? Because I can't apply here in paragraph tag, I cannot apply the id attribute. So impeat tag I type id is equal to in double quote which identify use here, that is para. Okay, so write down here or type here para. So para, save, and then execute this one. So you can see the output of this program. Okay, the text is aligned to center, border is display, and the font size is 20 pixels. Suppose I want to change the color, so add one attribute here, that is color. Color, I want to color here red. Okay, then see the output, save this document, and no need to change anywhere, directly see the output here. So the color of your text as well as border is changed to the red color. So in this way you have to apply more than one id in your document. But for one tag HTML, for one HTML, for one tag id attribute set at once. Okay, like h1 for h1 id attribute set as a heading one only. Okay, then for paragraph tag id attribute is set as only para. Okay, like this. So no repetition or no duplication of data allowed here. Okay, so that means id selector is specifies for what? Say specific for the elements, unique, or it is identified uniquely. Clear? Understand this one? So this is the execution of your id selector demo. Okay, so today we'll stop here. Thank you for watching this video. If like this video, or if you understand from this video, so please like it, subscribe it and share to your friends. Thank you.